from the White Mountain Community Health Center, and you are a navigator for the health marketplace. Mm-hmm. And we're going to talk about that, and we'll just start off. This program's been obviously going on for a year now, and your position has been there for about a year.
And
and I think this is exciting. There was stuff in the paper about you yesterday. I've heard about other things about the navigators, and I think what a great opportunity, because I think that's the first question. Well, I don't know what I'm doing. So that's what you're here for. So let's talk about that. What is a navigator going to do for people?
Well, I'm going to help people. Mostly the people I see are two categories. Either they're 45 and over and they don't know anything about computers, or they're in their 20s and 30s and they don't know anything about health insurance. It pretty much falls into those categories.
Yep.
And so I guide them through the process. I do it online if the system is working. Otherwise, we give a call and they'll help us through that.
And that's great. So, I mean, the law is now that everybody needs to have insurance.
Correct.
And so there are a lot of options. Last year in New Hampshire, there was one provider and about five choices or three choices. But this year, it's greatly improved.
Five different insurers, 40 plans.
That's a lot of plans.
That is a lot of plans.
So have you found so far that pretty much anybody who walks into your office, they can find something that fits their budget and fits their lifestyle?
Usually. Occasionally we get people who don't qualify for the financial help and they feel that the premiums are too high. Or some people that want to have a very low deductible but find they have to pay more for that per month than they really thought. But most people walk out happy.
Yeah, that's great. Mm-hmm. Because that's one of the things that we were discussing before. You need to have insurance, and it's one of those things. And it being affordable or at least approachable is what a great thing. So, and we were talking before too, a lot of the plans, as you say, there's a variety of them. Some have, you know, zero deductibles, some have no co-pays and everything else. And that's what you're going to do. You're going to help people with that and figure that stuff out.
Right. So the first thing is getting them through the whole process of applying online, creating accounts, that kind of thing. Then we get to the point where they see what they're eligible for. And that's like, okay, we're going to take a look now, and they're all hoping it's going to be good news, and it'll tell you how much of a credit that you would get to help pay for your monthly premiums.
Yeah.
So at that point, we go and look at all the different plans that they're eligible for, try to break it down. Well, there's four different categories: bronze, silver, gold, and platinum. Which ones kind of fit their needs? How often do they go to the doctors? Are they the type that never go, perfectly healthy? Well, they will need a different plan than someone that has a chronic illness.
Yeah. Now, can a family get if the family of four, can they get four different plans, or do you get a one family plan?
It starts out as a one family plan.
Mm-hmm.
But if you want to change that, you can. There's a screen that you can change it for different plans for different people.
So if somebody needed it, if they have more chronic or something like that,
mm-hmm.
or anything like that. Well, that's terrific, because in I don't want to say in real world insurance, you can't do that. You don't have that kind of flexibility.
Yeah, you can.
So that's great. And I have some cheat sheet notes here. So what are some of the advantages of buying the insurance through the marketplace versus I guess out on your own?
Right. Because the marketplace is the only place you can get financial help. You know, if you just go to a broker off the marketplace, there's going to be no help with your premiums or deductibles. But if you go in the marketplace, and the income levels are surprisingly high. For instance, a family of four can make up to $95,000 and still qualify for some help with their monthly premiums.
Wow, that's amazing.
Yeah.
And that's the stuff that you're going to help people with.
Mm-hmm.
So I guess probably the first and most important thing would be getting in touch with you guys, but not to be afraid of it. I'm sure that you have a lot of people who come in and they're scared. They're like, they don't want to spend the money. They don't think that they could possibly afford it. And that's what you're there for.
Right. A lot of people have tried on their own to go in, tried to get through the process. They're not good with computers, and they say, I just gave up. I gave up, and then I heard that you're there to help.
Yeah.
So that's when they come in.
Well, and of course, last year there were some glitches early on with the computers, and so people heard about that. I mean, that was the top news story. So then people were just kind of, but this is a new year. This is a year later. The plan has improved greatly in the year. Look at the options that we now have in New Hampshire.
Right.
And that's amazing. Now, do you also help people out if maybe they live in neighboring Maine?
We cannot.
You cannot, okay.
No, we have a grant specifically for New Hampshire. Yeah, but the hospital does help people who live in Maine.
Okay.
So, and they have what are called assisters that can help people through the process there.
So the solutions are out there. The help is out there. Mm-hmm. And what else? What else can we throw in about the healthcare marketplace that people need to know about?
They need to know the dates. So if they want to start coverage on January 1st, they have to apply by December 15th.
So that's coming up here
very quick. And then the whole process for this year ends February 15th. So after that, they cannot apply unless they have some special circumstance, like they got married, they have a baby, they move. Then they may be eligible to apply at any time during the year.
Right, changing in employment too will also allow that.
Yes.
If you
losing coverage, definitely.
Mm-hmm. So.
Yep, and I do want to say there are actually two plans in New Hampshire. One of them is what's called Expanded Medicaid or the New Hampshire Health Protection Program, and this is for low-income people. For a single person, it would be under $16,000. A family of four, under $32,000. Mm-hmm. They can get their insurance totally free, except maybe a few copays on their prescriptions.
Wow.
Yep.
So, and I guess that's the whole thing, is that people don't know this information.
Right. This is a new one.
This is a new one. And that's where you're going to help out.
Right.
Now, if people want to get in touch with you, they do it through the White Mountain Community Health Center.
Yep.
But what can people do if they're saying, okay, I'm going to go meet with Mary Jane next Wednesday? What can they do to kind of give themselves a little study time or whatever?
Right.
I mean, like you said, obviously a lot is online, I imagine there's some resources that they can kind of get some information ahead of time.
And if they have access to a computer, you can go and on the front page of healthcare.gov, you'll see look at plans and prices. So you can click on that, it'll ask you questions about your age, where you live, and your family. So it's probably five or six different questions.
Yeah.
Then it'll tell you whether you're probably eligible, how much of a credit you're eligible, will take you to all the plans and see how much each plan would cost you. So I encourage people to do that before they come, so that when they get there and we go through the process, then they will have an idea of what's gonna be good for them.
Right. And I would imagine that once they come speak with you too, you can tweak it a little because of the information that you have that perhaps, I wasn't thinking about that when I filled it out online.
Right, exactly.
And the thing is, I think I was just complaining about the computer earlier, I feel that I'm relatively computer savvy, but it seems like I can never get bookmarks to open and stuff like that.
Uh-huh.
And it's the same type of thing with the marketplace. There might be a little something that you're not looking at. I was unaware of the credit, for example. So I've learned stuff right now, and I imagine that a lot of people have those questions, but they need to act soon.
They do, yes. We're pretty booked up for the December 15th, but the hospital does have some openings. We just had an enrollment fair yesterday, so unfortunately the weather kept that down
out. Yeah.
But we will be having one in January and one in February that for after hours for people who can't come during the day.
That's terrific. Mm-hmm. Now, so let me ask that question. You said in January and February, but the deadline is December 15th.
If you want coverage starting January 1st.
Okay.
You can still enroll up through February 15th.
And then you'd have coverage March 1st.
March 1st, yep.
Well, see, I didn't know. I'm learning a lot here right now. So it's one of those things, and if you can't, ideally you want it for January 1st.
Right.
Now, if you had a plan last year that obviously was from last January to December 31st, does it automatically re-enroll?
Automatically re-enroll you if you do nothing. But everyone is encouraged to go back, update information, and look at your other options.
Mm-hmm. Because this year, because now we have a lot of options
right.
here in New Hampshire.
A lot of options.
So that's great. Well, that's very good to know. I didn't know about the that you could do it in January for February 1st mm-hmm. and March 1st. So that's great
yep.
too.
Yep.
Now, are there one of the other things? Obviously, with the healthcare, people are required to have health insurance now. Is that true?
That is true. There are some cases where you can get exemptions if you don't earn enough money. If you already have employer coverage from your job, then you do not have to get any marketplace insurance. You're all covered.
Yeah. Well, that's great. So I guess we've got, do we have a phone number there at the bottom? We do have a phone number there at the bottom. I had to look, it's on a little thing. So they could give you a call and try to set up an appointment and mm-hmm. and definitely get some information.
Right.
But like you say, the first step is to go online and find out as much information as you can. Then I'm sure that makes your job easier when they show up there.
Much easier. Yep.
All righty.
And they have to have an idea of what they're going to make in 2015 because they'll have to estimate it.
Yeah.
And for some people, that's easy because they make the same every week. But for people who are self-employed, that can be tricky.
Right.
So they make the best guess, and then if halfway through the year they find that they were off, they have to let the marketplace know and
okay.
they'll adjust their premiums.
Plus or minus.
Yep. Plus or minus.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Well, that's great to know. So,
yep.
So in other words, you're not locked into something if all of a sudden the bottom drops out of what you're doing.
Or, right.
All right.
Right.
Well, I think that's an important thing to know, too. So mm-hmm. I'm learning so much today. This is terrific. So thank you so much for coming down today.
Sure.
And letting us know about this. And some closing remarks. What do you want to kind of throw out there for people?
The marketplace is a great thing, I think. People are so happy when they're able to get affordable health insurance, sometimes for the first time in their lives.
It's amazing. It's absolutely.
I had a 64-year-old woman last year. First time in her life she was ever able to afford health insurance.
Wow. That's yep. terrific.
Yep.
That's terrific. Well, Mary Jane, thank you so much for coming down.
Sure.
So you can contact the White Mountain Community Health Center, get some information for them. You also said the hospital is also doing stuff. And there are a lot of other resources, too, but people can get some help with the marketplace. It's one of those things you don't have to try to go at it alone.
No. And for some people, it's a lot better not to try.
Yeah. There you go. Well, Mary Jane, thank you so much for coming down.
You're welcome.
And we'll be back here in a minute on White Mountains Today.